54 on the loop. WLUP Chicago. Sunny and warm. High today, mid-50s. That's Jimi Hendrix Easel. Playing on the live loop. Hey, yeah, hey, huh, hey, oh.
Earlier I said Cleopatra, not Cleopatra.
It's Jimi Hendrix Easel. Jimmy, who are you?
My name's Jimmy, man, and I hope everybody's listening out there.
They are listening, my man. You're live at the Love Dart Lounge this morning here.
Huh?
You're live at the Love Dart Lounge. One morning I came in. Just keep playing while I talk to you. More of a storytelling riff. And on the morning I came in to the radio station, and Scotty Dirks, who was working overnight, said to me, "Hey, I got this guy named Jimmy."
Yeah.
He said, "Jimmy be calling me all night long. Anytime you want to throw in a little part of the story, you can too." And Jimmy called on the loop.
Sure did.
And he said, "Hey, I want to play. Hey, I want to play."
That's right.
So he left me a note and I said, "Hey, baby, I'll get back to you as soon as I can." And I got back to him as soon as I could, and I called him, and he did, and he came and he went and he played, yeah. And his name was Jimi Hendrix Easel. And we woke up Mr. Hendrix one morning, just about a week ago, and he said, "Hey, that man can play. How?
Yeah, how? Yeah.
We got needles in our arm in the morning, yeah. What do you do for a living, Jimmy, when you're not just here trying to get a gig on the radio and playing your music so that people can hear and love?
Well, I work down here at 1233 South Michigan.
He said he works down here at 1233 South Michigan. What do you do, my man?
I work for Graf International.
No, man, you got to sing it. We don't want to say it.
Oh, yeah. For Mr. and Mrs. G.
What do you do down there?
I sell drills for Mr. G.
Sells the drills for Mr. G. Sells some drills for Mr. G. Yeah, 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 yeah. How can that be?
He's good to me, you know.
He's good to me. He's good to me. I sell drills for Mr. B. Mr. B. Mr. G.
'Cause nobody knows.
Nobody knows.
Like he knows.
'Cause he knows his drill bits, baby.
Know.
You want a drill bit?
Call Mr. G.
You want a drill bit?
Call Mr. G.
You want a screwdriver?
Call Mr. G.
You want anything in the world that you can screw and play with? It's Mr. G. So your name is Jimi Hendrix Easel. That's your middle name. You like to play the guitar, but you don't play lame.
Yeah, I'll do a little trick for you, Grandma.
I'm listening. He's playing with his teeth right now. He's playing with his teeth. I swear to God. Ow. Ow.
Ow, ow, ow.
Ow, ow, ow. He's playing. Ow. Oh. Get your tongue on that one part there. Oh, look out, my man. Look out. Don't want to burn that tongue. That special little tongue of yours, Mr. Jimmy. Listen, man, I love to have you stopping by and playing for us today in the Love Dart Lounge. We got to do some news now. You know what I'm talking about?
All right.
Switch gears. One, two, we'll do a news song now. I've never seen you before, have I?
Nope.
I've never met you in person, have I?
No, sir.
But yet, ladies and gentlemen, I feel a camaraderie. I feel a bond blowing with me and a young black man named Jimi Hendrix Easel. This sounds like Crazy Elephant. From the land of Georgia. Do you sing like Jimi Hendrix?
Oh yeah, let me try to do a little something for you.
Alright, do one song by Hendrix.
Alright, go something like that. All right. The words might be a little bit wrong, but you know, it'll sound alright, I guess.
It does not matter.
I ain't no pro, okay?
So that's alright.
Here you go anyway.
Welcome back to the Love Dud Lounge with Jimi Hendrix Easel, the man who handles the phones at a shipping center. Stop. Put your hand right there. That. Okay. All right. Calm down, man. Let's chill out here a minute. You cool? Cool, man?
Yeah, I think so, man.
You're freaking out over here. Just back it down. Cool down. Gonna have to get you some water. We're gonna have to get you some. Is there a paramedic in the Hancock Center? We're gonna need a paramedic.
Oh man, I'm telling you, you better get him quick.
And you went out of your mind. Okay, now just cool down. Cool down. Just relax. We're gonna hold on a minute here.
All right.
Now
I'm with
see
you,
if you can just flick that switch and turn that thing into a banjo, okay?
That's incredible.
That is the coolest switch.
Yeah.
How do you do that? How do you do that, Jimmy?
It's simple. Just
Buzz.
Do it.
All right.
9:02 in the morning loop. I'm Buzz Kilman with these top stories. In New York City this morning, they're bracing up for the impending arrival of Mikhail Gorbachev and wife Reza. There are about 6,600 policemen working overtime in anticipation of unmanageable crowds and traffic that could prove to be a veritable nightmare.
We could have gridlock.
Gorbachev will make an appearance at the UN. He'll have a meeting with President Reagan and George Bush. He reportedly will visit a soup kitchen. Next stop on that tour, Cuba. A U.S. Army spokeswoman says Soviet inspectors were very pleased with the way the destruction of two Pershing 2 missile motors went yesterday. They were the first two of 400 that will be destroyed at an Army facility east of Pueblo, Colorado, under the terms of the Intermediate Nuclear Forces Treaty. Other missiles have been destroyed at an Army ammunition plant in Texas. No word yet on what caused a B-52 bomber to crash early today at the Air Force base in Michigan. The Air Force says all 8 crew members survived that crash, but some suffered broken bones. A spokesman says the plane burst into flames as it was making a practice landing. NASA says the shuttle will land today at 5:36 Chicago time. It'll land, however, at Edwards Air Force Base in California. And because it's been on a military mission, spectators will not be allowed to watch. Rich Daley, now the official candidate for mayor. It's his second mayoral campaign, and he has a couple of years of speaking lessons behind him, so he's pretty enthusiastic.
It's time for a new beginning in Chicago. I may not be the best speaker in town, but I know how to run a government and how to bring people together. I've done that in the last 20 years in public life. Delegate to the Constitutional Convention, state's senator, and his state's attorney.
Adding to Daley's confidence has to be the recent polls, which put him 15 percentage points ahead of his nearest rival, Alderman Tim Evans, whose supporter, Alderman Dorothy Tillman, was one of the first to feel the heat of the Daley campaign.
Everybody should repudiate Dorothy Tillman's remarks against the mayor of the city of Chicago. I mean, you can maybe disagree with someone's leadership quality, but again, we're getting back to the name-calling, and you know what? It doesn't accomplish anything. It doesn't accomplish anything. Because you have to get on with the city government. And Gene Sawyer is going to be running for mayor of the city of Chicago, and I don't think name-calling should be involved in this campaign.
Of course, Dorothy Tillman spent much of last week attending Harold Washington memorials, during which she kept calling Mayor Sawyer and Uncle Tom. 15 Republicans appeared before officials at the GOP in Cook County, prepared to select a mayoral candidate last night. Two possible candidates are former Mayor Jane Byrne and former Alderman Edward Doliak, who reportedly is interested. Ward committeemen will vote on a slate tomorrow night. Terrible Tommy O'Connor would be 98 years old if he were alive today, but it's doubtful he would be capable of the fancy footwork that earned him a page in Chicago criminal history 67 years ago. This Sunday, O'Connor made a spectacular escape from the old Cook County Jail, where he was waiting to be hung in 4 days for the murder of a Chicago police detective, Patrick O'Neill. Terrible Tommy has not been seen since. 9:05 on the Morning Loop. We'll be back with Bruce Wolf, live from Anaheim.
How you doing, everybody? I'm Chet Kopic. Hey, you know what? I've had 9 pairs of slacks taken in already. How did I do it? Because I finally broke the diet merry-go-round. I finally got off the diet merry-go-round. I made the call that mattered. I got a hold of Nutrisystem. 1-800-777-THIN. Christmas time. And you know what happens during the holiday season? You party a little bit, you make the social scene, all of a sudden, the waistline gets a workout. The average person is going to gain 4 to 7 pounds during the Christmas season, but you can break the trend. You can reverse the trend. You can lose weight before St. Nicholas makes the annual visit. But I'll tell you what, don't wait another day. Contact Nutrisystem, 1-800-777-THIN. Get rid of the diet frustration. Do what I did. Make the plunge because you're going to love it. It's going to be safe. It's going to be simple. And your waistline, your hips, they're going to slim down. Contact Nutrisystem, 1-800-777-THIN. Believe me, they'll go to bat for you.
Hello, Ralph speaking.
Hey, Ralph. It's Ted. How are things at the studio?
Not bad. Say, you're not calling with another last-minute order, are you?
No, but I am calling about our last order.
Okay, what was wrong?
Nothing, Ralph. The charts were beautiful. The art and photographs, they were fantastic. Everything was perfect.
Well, that's a relief. Then why the call, Ted?
Well, I know you and your crew had to work right through the holiday weekend, and I just wanted you to know that we really appreciate the time and effort you put into our project.
Hey, wait a minute. Are you saying what I think you're saying?
Yeah, Ralph, I'm saying thanks.
Wow.
What's the matter?
Nothing. I don't know what to say. I mean, most people just don't take the time to, you know, call and say
Well, you guys are terrific. Thanks again.
No, thank you. Huh? You just made my day.
Oh. Illinois Bell would like to remind you, if you want to get ahead in business, don't take all the credit. Pick up the phone and share it. Just call.
We got style. A little something extra, something to fit your every mood. So smile, we're everything you want to be.
Hey, you do a lot. You know that. We know that. That's why we've got a lot for you at Fashion Bug and Fashion Bug Plus. That's why we carry thousands of styles to fit everything you do. Clothes for work or school, clothes for dressing up, clothes for laying back. At Fashion Bug and Fashion Bug Plus, you'll find all the latest styles in sportswear, dresses and suits, outerwear and accessories, in junior, misses and plus sizes. And the prices? You'll love them.
You can work with us or play with us. Relax and run away with us. You'll kid with us, cause we're everything you do. Fashion Bug, styles to fit every you.
The Sale of America. New York, Los Angeles, Chicago. Something must be done. Preferred Capital Group. Securing tomorrow, today. Capitalize on the opportunity.
The news was sponsored by Fashion Bug and Fashion Bug Plus, where you'll find styles to fit every you. And now checking traffic at 9:09 on the Morning Loop. The Dan Ryan is jammed into 75th in the locals and solid from Pershing to just before the Stevenson ramp where there's an accident. It's 35 from 95th, jammed on the Ike from north to the Tri-State, and from central to Damon, 20 from Mannheim. The Kennedy is stop and go from the Northwest Tollway all the way to Western with a gaper's delay from an outbound accident. 50 from O'Hare, 25 from Montrose, and 10 in the express lanes. Outbound is jammed from Damon most of the way to the junction where there was an earlier accident, and there's an accident with injuries mixed in at Western, 35 minutes out to the airport. The Edens heavy, 2E to the junction, 20 from Dempster to Montrose. Southbound Lakeshore Drive, heavy Lawrence almost all the way to Chicago Avenue. Northbound Tri-State on the brakes approaching the 290. The CTA is rerouting the number 60 Blue Island and the number 151 Sheridan buses around the scene of an earlier fire near Jackson and Wacker. Jackson is closed between Wacker and Franklin is blocked off between Van Buren and Jackson because of that fire. That's shadow traffic. I'm Ashley Knight, now with sports live from Anaheim. Here's Bruce Wolf.
say, my man?
How the Bears lost. Game, how?
The Bears lost.
How?
The Bears lost.
And that controversial call on the alleged fumble by Neil Anderson. And furthermore, at least the Bears were in it until the second half because L.A. had to settle for field goals in the first half when it could have possibly hit touchdowns. The Bears lost 23-3 to the Rams. Jim Harbaugh didn't look all that good, but he was rushed by that blitzing Ram defense. It was Monday night, his first start, and maybe his last, because Jim McMahon indicated after the game he hopes to be ready for the Lions. The Lions start Ben Bennett against them. And Mike Ditka, how did you feel about this performance?
The Rams are a lot better team than the record indicated, and they came out and played, and they did what they had to do to win the football game. We did not operate very well on offense. It's hard to say why. You know, it'd be easy to say it was quarterback's fault. I think that's a cop-out. It wasn't his fault any more than anybody else, the coaches or the players.
Don't forget the Bears and the Lions coming up on Sunday. The Bulls face the Celtics tonight at the stadium. The game on AM 1000 at 7 o'clock. The Cubs made a trade yesterday. They sent Rafael Palmeiro and Jamie Moyer to Texas for pitchers Paul Kilgus and Mitch Williams and shortstop Curtis Wilkerson. And though the Bear players would never admit it, you have to wonder if the defense lost its edge in the second half because it lost confidence in the offense's ability to move the ball. The Bears could keep intercepting, but if the offense couldn't score or even control the ball, well, at some point you just pull out of Vietnam if it's going to be a no-win situation. I'll tell you, though, I think the Bears just gave up right about the time of the Brian Boitano interview by Frank Gifford. True, the Bears did intercept a couple after that interview, but L.A. was clearly on the offensive at that point. Jim Everett's passing and the Ram defense were bad enough, but Brian Boitano interrupting a Bear game as if a football audience cares about him, that just sucks the drive right out of you. That's Sports on the Loop. I'm Bruce Wolf.
Sunny and mild today. The high should be about 55 degrees. Partly cloudy tonight, the low 37. And tomorrow, partly sunny and colder, the high around 40. It's 35 at O'Hare, 37 at Midway, 36 degrees lakefront. At 9:13 on the Loop, WLUP, AM and FM, Chicago.
You got a good sound coming out of that amp. You hear that buzzing?
Yeah.
Pow! We're back at the Love Dart Lounge. Jimi Hendrix Easel is here. Jimmy, listen, my man. So many special people want to hear Hendrix songs, but we just don't have a lot of time, my man. But you got a sound all your own, and can I ask you a question?
Yeah, man, for sure.
I want to know what you do with that rare talent you've got. You've got a love for Jimi Hendrix. I know that. What do you do with the talent, my man? You play in a band.
That's right, man. Trying to get something together here.
But you don't have a band, do you?
No. Still need one.
So you
can't. Serious people.
You don't want to play with anybody who wants to play top 40?
No.
No tile or ribbon around the YOLO tree?
Oh, no.
Then what do you want, my special man?
Somebody knows something about that. Or either this. Can you see me? Yeah.
Yeah.
Baby, you on my knee.
That's great, Jimmy. I gotta tell you, man, smoke in this room is unbelievable. So keep playing, huh?
You think they know anything about this? Listen to y'all listeners out here.
Hold on. Jimmy, now your uncle's here. He's the one that brought you down here.
That's right, man.
To play. Come on over, Sylvester. Come on over to the mic.
Yeah, right on.
How are you, my special
man?
Man?
What's happening?
Now, you got a musical shop in town, according to the card you just handed me.
Right.
And what's the name of that special little place you call?
That's called Sylvester Buy and Sell New and Used Instruments, man.
Yeah?
Yep.
And what do you do down there at that special place?
Oh, we take in trades from bands all around the city of Chicago, near Northside, on 2500 North California.
You buy and sell?
Yeah, we buy and sell
buy
guitars,
and sell.
Amps. I sold Jimmy his first guitar, and he's been doing good ever since then. And we like to tell everybody that Jimmy do need a job, and he would like to play on the weekend with somebody. Any band can hook up with him, and we can do some of the gigs around Chicago town.
He's got a job working at the Graff International. He answers the phone, and he handles the shipping and receiving. But he's got a real desire to get out and play rock and roll.
only on a weekend.
Right.
Light me up.
So, if they need to get in contact with us, Jimmy, to play with them, or if they need to buy a new or used guitar, come by or call Sylvester at 227-1047. That's Sylvester's on North California, 2500. Right.
He said 227-1047.
That's right. That's where you can get in touch with the man of Jimi Hendrix. All right. So y'all listen to us and y'all do that for us. All right.
Give him a call.
Y'all out there.
He'd love to jam with you. Jimmy, come back to the mic, my man. Thanks for being in the Love Dot Lounge with us today, my man.
Thanks a lot for having me.
And I wish you best success playing weddings or whatever, as long as you turn it up really, really, really loud and you light a lot of cigarettes.
Right, I heard that.
Yeah. All right, Jimmy.
Wait.
Why do you think? I think he's ODing.
Chicago's Loop FM.